Oh, it was the biggest rush. I think I've one of the biggest rushes you could possibly have.
Pull her back, pull the nose up.
A new program promises to have you flying in no time and for about the cost of a nice dinner and a movie. As the cost of airline travel continues to rise, the number of private pilots in the United States is at a 30-year low.
A new program is taking aim at people who may have never even set foot in a plane. The Aircraft Owners and Pilots Association want you to take the controls and learn how fun and economical it can be to fly a small plane. Tonight, Channel 13's Dan Winters shows us one flight might be all it takes to get you hooked. It's new at 10.
It all begins when you shell out hundreds of dollars for a ticket. You have to arrive early, stand in line, check your bags, stand in line, take off your shoes, and receive the wand. It's a process Jeff Alascio is sick and tired of.
I would tell you that I'm, on average, out of town 3 nights a week. So I try to be home on Monday and Friday. Doesn't always work that way.
Jeff says the airlines don't always work either. He says they're expensive and they can't always get him to clients who live in smaller cities. Jeff sells car washes for Ryko Corporation of Grimes. About a month ago, he started making this trip to the private side of the Des Moines airport. Jeff says getting his private pilot's license was the gateway to serve his customers better.
Make that a day trip to, you know, South Dakota or Omaha or, you know, Grand Island. It's a big deal.
And it's a lot more fun.
Okay, you're going to check the belt to make sure it's tight.
To fly himself. During a pre-flight check, Jeff explains that once you're past the initial investment to learn, flying costs a lot less than most people think. Lessons run between $4,000 and $7,000. That's typically cheaper than a two-year degree at Des Moines Area Community College. That runs about $6,000. If you join a flying club, you can reserve and rent planes for as long as you like. The club maintains them. You only pay for the hours you're in the air. For example, let's say that today you and three friends want to fly to Chicago for the weekend. It'll run about $60 per person round trip. No advance ticket on the airline could cost more than $600. Plus, the private flight would get you there in a fraction of the time, about an hour and a half faster.
These are actually probably less expensive once you get your license to use for business and personal travel than a car, especially with the price of fuel today with a car. I mean, it's $33 a gallon.
And flying can take you farther. Just ask Jody Weisenberger. She recently returned from a trip to Florida with her husband and two children.
You know, being in between a cloud layer where you've got this beautiful sunset and a strip of blue, that's just, you can't really imagine.
Now Jody and her family imagine endless destinations. She says, best of all, they travel on their own terms.
Not worry about getting to the airport to go through security and check baggage and just hop in and go.
And look at where they've gone. These are pictures from Puerto Rico and Hawaii.
This is Glacier Bay, flying through Glacier Bay.
Jody took just 6 months to get her private pilot's license, another year to get her instrument license. She says you can go at your own pace, and just like a workout, it's easy to find time to work in a lesson.
Even just an hour, 45 minutes, practice takeoffs and landings and get used to it and start learning.
All of these instruments and gauges look pretty confusing to someone who's never flown a plane before, someone like, well, me. So to find out if it's really as simple as it sounds, I'm gonna jump in the cockpit here with Steve Davis, a certified flight instructor, and find out if flying could really be for you.
So you gotta be careful not to push on the brakes when you don't mean to.
I'm taking part in a nationwide program called Project Pilot, where for $59, Steve lets beginners take the controls.
We're gonna go full throttle, and you're gonna have your hands on the controls. Mm-hmm. I'm not. You're going to use your feet to keep it going straight down the runway.
As we speed down the runway, Steve's calm voice gives the instruction.
Can I just raise the nose just a little bit?
And lets me take off.
There you go. Now put the nose about on the horizon. So look out over the outside.
Traffic.
Look outside and then just balance the nose so it's right on the horizon. I'm going to trim it down just a little bit. So let the nose down a little bit.
Within seconds, we're high above downtown. It's exhilarating to guide the plane over Gray's Lake and Principal Park.
Ankeny traffic, Cherokee 9600 jet. We're 4 miles south.
Minutes later, we're ready to land in Ankeny.
And just make a nice, smooth touchdown. Good job. Nice
wow.
Landing.
We check the traffic and taxi around.
My face hurts from smiling so much.
And it's up and away for a return trip to Des Moines.
Then raise the nose off the ground just a little bit. Pull her back, pull the nose up, wings level. There you go.
But most people that experience it, that try it, that go up to fly, get addicted to it. Because it's just, it is just, it's the ultimate high, so to speak.
Steve says the number of people experiencing the ultimate high is at a 30-year low. That's why he's using Project Pilot to share his passion for flying with others.
So there's not as many people flying as there was. There's certainly a drive, you know, from Project Pilot to get more people back up in the air. That's where this $59 introductory ride comes from.
Almost 50 flight schools across Iowa participate in the program. You can find instructors at this website, beapilot.com. You can learn about the cost and job opportunities that are open to pilots, or, like Jody's husband did, you can give a friend or family member the gift of flight.
Oh, it was the biggest rush. I think one of the biggest rushes you could possibly have.
To me, I like flying. I've always liked flying, so it's a blast to begin with. But from a business, I don't see a reason not to.
Where else can you go 140 miles per hour in Des Moines and not get a speeding ticket? Huh?
Something to think about next time you shell out a few $100 to start to wait in line. In and over Des Moines, Dan Winters, Channel 13 News.
Hey, that's a good point about the speeding tickets. I like that. If you feel inspired to give flying a try, we've set up a couple of links on our website that can help you get started. Just log on to whotv.com and click on the As Seen on Channel 13 tab at the top of the homepage.